Now, I'm expecting this to be a bit better. I'm hoping they've taken the brawler elements of Battletoads and made more of it. I'm hoping they've done less of that Ghostbusters 2 dangly on a bungee thing. Because let's face it, that was a noise to express how I felt about that. Now, Double Dragon, awesome. The Ultimate Team, I'd say Double Dragon are cooler than Battletoads. That's just my opinion. I may be wrong about that. Answers on a postcard. Double Dragon might make this cooler. I think I have played this before once or twice. And again, I don't think I warmed to it particularly. Nice bit of big, juicy, sprightly graphics. That's not a sprite, clearly. It's going to be... I mean, not an in-game sprite. But it implies that the graphics are going to be bigger and more detailed and generally better drawn. Look at the muscles on that Toad. I mean, really... Jesus wept. They are muscly toads. Let's see a Double Dragon, guys. Let's see how they look. And the dragons from the streets, because they've got a brick wall background. Check them out. It's Bimmy Lee. He looks kind of cool. Kind of weirdly drawn. Kind of cool, though. And it's Jilly Lee. He's got a hole in his shoulder. I hope someone got fired for that. He's got weird hands as well. Versus, oh yeah, we're getting a full character rundown. I like this. I love all this stuff though. I love all these, like, check out Ababo. There's veiny little arms. It was actually pointing there, but it was lost on me because the perspective was a bit wrong. Big Blag, see, I don't really like it. I don't like the Battletoads characters very much. I don't know why. This copies the Turtles characters, aren't they? Roper. He's not Roper, he's Mr. Big, or whatever his name was, the Shadow Boss. Roper. Whoa. I'm scared. I don't like him. No, I don't like he's scary. He's actually scaring me. Shadow Boss. See, that's not the Shadow Boss I know. Oh no, are we going with some kind of weird licensing twist on the Dark Queen? Yeah, we know you. You're like Shredder Lady. And Beak Dude. Right, okay. We get it. Let's rematch. Okay. Now, I'm hoping this has more Brawler and less Rope. That's what I'm hoping. And I'm going to pick a Double Dragon character because... Oh, that's a bit lazy, isn't it? We'll draw his eyes looking to the right and change his hair. I want to be Bimmy. I want to see if this stands up to Double Dragon by having a Double Dragon thing. And I hope that's a map and not the game, because that is tiny. I've got a terrible feeling. No, it will be the map. It will be the map. Okay. Too small. It's all too small. And it plays like a Battletoads game. Not enough animation. It's all too small. Got that slide forward. I actually quite like that slide forward when you move thing now. I don't like this diagonal floor thing going on. Like, that isn't accurate at all. Look at that. I have played this before where they're clinging onto the sides. I've got no problem with that. They're trying to do something a bit differently. Have that. What did I just pick up there? It's all slippery though, and Double Dragon's a bit more... Actually, Double Dragon is quite a slippery game. If you play Double Dragon, slippery and jagged to play on the arcade, compared with Streets of Rage. But that's because it's compared with Streets of Rage, which, let's face it, is a better, though later, game. So in context, maybe it's not that much to write home about. Because in context, Double Dragon had nothing to copy from, really, except Renegade, which was their previous attempt. And let's face it, imagine, well, Ocean... beat the hell out of the arcade version of Renegade with their Spectrum version, which was, I don't care what you say, the best version, and Target Renegade, which was better still. In fact, the best Renegade game ever made was Target Renegade for the Spectrum. The kids of today might find that hard to believe based on the fact that the Spectrum had such limited graphics capabilities, but play the game a bit and play the other versions if you doubt it. The Amstrad version of Target Renegade actually is pretty good, but it's not as good as the Spectrum version. It's not as well designed and well made as the Spectrum version. Don Drake and Mike Lamb are like my gaming heroes from when I was growing up. They were like, you know, they'll never know it, but if I could have worked with someone back in the day making games, it would have been them. I saw that coming. Have some of that. Sorry, off on a tangent, retro gaming, which I was quite enjoying. So where were we? Yeah, and they made some good games. Target Renegade was their finest work, I think. And Loved it. I loved it. It was my favourite game growing up. And the only beat 'em up I think that was better than it was Streets of Rage for the Mega Drive. Streets of Rage 2, in fact, for the Mega Drive. Again, in context, Streets of Rage was a better game because they didn't have anything to... The whole grab move thing that they really pioneered didn't have anything to copy from in terms of that particular move. But what Renegade did have, which was really cool and underused by the player often, was the punch the enemy on the ground move, which was actually brilliant, a master touch, and allowed you to be brilliant at the game if you knew how to use it. In fact, I always wanted to make a brawler that combined the best elements of Streets of Rage with the best elements of Renegade, and I am capable of doing it. It's just such a time consumer that one day I will savour the experience of doing it, I think. Anyone who knows my game development will know I've only published or released kind of old style shmup, which was good. It was all right as a game goes, which borrowed all the best bits I could find from the likes of Project X, R-Type and Hellfire. Not so much R-Type actually, but people say it looked a bit like R-Type. I don't think so, but I thought it looked more like Project X. But its playstyle was very much borrowed from Hellfire. Which we'll be covering, I guess, in a later video, the whole weapon select thing. And in the same way, I'd like to do a brawler based on all my favourite bits of... That's inconsistent, isn't it? I can't walk up that, but I can walk up the more steep ones before. I'd like to do a brawler based on my favourite elements of brawlers. This, by the way, is not one of my favourite brawlers. It's just so... I don't know, I wish I could... articulate it a bit better. It's a bit dull, to be fair. I mean, I know what I'm doing. I know I've got to do to fight these baddies. Dodge that. It's all a bit samey and repetitive. And, oh, it's Abobo. Maybe he'll perk things up a bit. I like the funny little eye thing. That's quite good. They got consistency with the style of the sprites in the original Double Dragon game. The playability is nothing like it. It's better in some ways. It's a bit rubbisher in others. But he's recognisable as the Abobo from the original Double Dragon arcade. And I like that. Something about his face and his proportions. The same with Bimmy Lee there. He's got kind of a consistency about him, even though he's completely redrawn. I don't like how small the sprites are. I'm not really into that. I like big, juicy sprites. I know... Oh, bye. Bye then. Ooh. I can kind of see why they've gone with it. It works for this particular game, and it's, you know... It's not just a straight left to right brawler, you've got these kind of other sections. this is more brawlery. I was expecting another dangling on a rope scene. I'm hoping that we can just bypass those. It's the big rat dude. Let's have him. Oh yeah, cool look, Double Dragon baddies. Double Dragon type baddies. Although there's never anyone with a Mohican in the original Double Dragon game. Is that a Mohican? It's just a spiky haircut, isn't it? But I like it. He looks very Double Dragon. He's got studs on his belt. He's got studs on wristbands. Who wears wristbands with studs on? Double Dragon baddies, that's who. And 80s gangs, which I guess is what Double Dragon was kind of about. The warriors and all that in it. Come out and play. Oh, no, really? Where's the jump? Oh, that's silly. No, I'm not even bothering with them. We're going that way, and then we're going that way. And we're not climbing. I'm just not climbing. Oh, jump kick. Hey, nice jump kick. I like the arm position and stuff. Don't like the way he doesn't really make any progress across the screen. Can I do a double button move? Oh, maybe not. I know in some versions of Double Dragon, that kick, that jump kick then, that finishing move he did, was like something you'd do if you held both buttons down and he'd spin around. A bit like Final Fight, you know, when they do like the rah move that spins around. You know what I mean? Oh, that's cool. That spins around and, you know, knocks everyone down when you get a bit overwhelmed. Final Fight had to use that because, let's face it, it had nothing but standard attacks and jump kicks other than that move that span around. Anyway, this is getting better. I like the charm of this stuff where you knock them through the floor and that. This is good. We've got Double Dragon baddies. Actually, I much prefer this to Battletoads. And it's a boss time, or at least a sub-boss. But my time is up. That was a much better game than Battletoads. Although not as good as like the Streets of Rage as brawlers go. But kind of cool. That was Battletoads and Double Dragon on the Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.